Good evening. Namaste. Myself, Dr. Suhail. I'm assistant professor in the Department of General Medicine in Rame Medical College. Okay, today I'd like to talk to you regarding something which is very common and very much neglected by us. You know, it's something called as dyslipidemia. You may be heard about lipid profile, lipids, cholesterol and all. So let's discuss briefly about this dyslipidemia. On this World Health Day, we need to discuss more about diseases which are less often spoken, but when they go for complications, they'll deal with disastrous things. So one such thing is dyslipidemia. Dyslipidemia is nothing but abnormal levels of blood cholesterols. When you're talking about blood cholesterol, there are various types of blood cholesterols. You might have heard about good cholesterol, bad cholesterol. Yes. There are two types of cholesterol, HDL and LDL, are two components of cholesterol team. So this LDL is nothing but low-density lipoprotein. HDL is called high-density lipoprotein. This LDL, along with the triglyceride, which is also a part of cholesterol, combines together to form a very massive problem to your blood vessels in form of plaques and all, in form of atherosclerotic plaques in long-standing forms. Whereas HDL cholesterol, this good cholesterol mobilizes the part of the bad cholesterol which is there in the lumen to the other part, like liver and all. So what we need a good cholesterol more in the body, bad cholesterol less in the body. But since it is a very silent mechanism occurring in our body, we hardly see any changes like in form of symptoms, like we see in diabetes and hypertension, in dyslipidemia. This will be seen in the form of complication. Once the patient finally develops heart attack, the patient finally develops brain stroke, or when the patient finally develops some peripheral vascular disease, then only you'll come to know what this actually have to happen. So what we have to do, there are a few steps which you people have to take in the form of, like, anyways you go for a routine health checkup, never forget to check your lipid profile, the fasting lipid profile. First step is go for a routine, like once you're across 35-40 years of age, you need to go a regular blood checkups. Okay, yearly ones, it's very mandatory to check your fasting lipid profile. In the fasting lipid profile, basically you need to focus on three important components: HDL, LDL, and triglycerides. Sometimes the triglycerides and LDL will be underlying markers for you to tell that the patient may go for full-blown diabetes, hypertension, or hypothyroidism. Okay, so we need to address this. Initially, what we can do for these altered cholesterol levels, then what if the patient doesn't have diabetes, hypertension, or any other comorbidities, you can actually advise the patient for a diet modification. We know many people consume too much of saturated fatty acids, too much of red meat, okay, ghee, butter, and all. What we can do is we can counsel them regarding the same nutritious food which can be gained by elsewhere. For example, instead of red meat, go for a lean meat, go for a fish. Okay, we also have low fat, in fact, free fat milk products. We have a yogurt, and ask them to take more about fruits and vegetables. Okay, like we have got some exotic avocado also. So like this, we need to guide the patient regarding what substitutes can be done from converting the saturated fatty acids to monounsaturated. Okay, second step, what we can tell regarding dyslipidemia, apart from the medicine, is exercise. Every day, a 30 minutes walk or a swimming, some aerobic activity for at least 5 days a week is sufficient for them to maintain a good cholesterol level. Any exercise which increases the heart rate, which makes the body sweat, it's very beneficial to burn the fat. And also recently, you know, we have the tech gadgets and all where people see how many calories they are burning and all, and seeing the fat content, the calorie content in the dietary literature of the food. It's very helpful for us to keep updated how many calories you have taken, what fat content you have taken. And third thing, if the patient's sugar cholesterols are not well controlled, despite proper exercise, despite diet, then we need to go with the medications. Medication starting early is a boon for patient to prevent any catastrophic complications in future. If you see a long-standing person who has never examined cholesterol, suddenly he might land up with a full-blown heart attack, MI, or a full-blown paralysis, stroke, which may ultimately lead to death. Even the patient doesn't die, he may go for a disability, which is very painstaking to the family. So what I request, what I insist people, don't forget regularly to check their fasting lipid profile. You demand for it every visit whenever you go for a checkup, routine checkup, yearly ones for a fasting lipid profile, and make sure your LDL, HDL, triglycerides are checked by a physician and properly guided to you what medicine or what lifestyle modification is needed in order to improve your health, for not just for you, for your family and for your whole community. Thank you.